Hello, Penn High School. I'm your anchor, Maui.
And I'm Brandon Hall. Welcome to this week's edition to PNN. Let's get into it.
Penn High School Work Experience students are conducting a food drive to benefit the Mishawaka Food Pantry. The food drive is scheduled for September 19th through the 30th. Non-perishable items may be brought to the bins located in room 181.
All sophomores and juniors are scheduled to take the 2022 PSAT/NMSQT Wednesday, October 12th. All freshmen will take the PSAT Tuesday, October 9th. All costs are covered by the IDOE or PHM. Penn will have a modified schedule for the school day to accommodate this testing. Homeschooled and other non-Penn students must register with Mr. Hall in the testing office. For more details, contact Mr. Hall at dhall@phm.k12.in.us.
Attention students, if you would like to retake your school picture, picture retakes are scheduled for Monday, October 10th. They will be available to all students every block in between the basketball court and the cafeteria.
The PHM DVT Planetarium showed Legends of the Night Sky, Perseus/Andromeda, and presented the Fall Night Sky live Thursday, September 22nd at 6:30 p.m. Tickets were $5 for adults and $3 for students and senior citizens. This show engaged the audience with a wonderful story filled with humorous and exciting characters and also engaged their desire to learn about astronomy.
Play auditions for the first play of 22-23 was God's Diary. Auditions were on Wednesday, September 21st after school in the Studio Theater. It was held until 6 p.m. The first show was November 18th, Friday, and involved rehearsals.
Now with this week's social calendar.
Hello everyone, I'm Megan Getzik here to bring you this week's Penn Social Calendar. If you're into board and card games, then you're along. The Tabletop Game Club is held in the IMC on Mondays from 3:30 to 4:30. If you're looking to run a campaign as a Dungeon Master, or duel in Yu-Gi-Oh! Or Magic the Gathering, you can sign up in Miss Swords Ribbon 137. Are you interested in learning about other countries and cultures? 84 Food, 180s Around the World is a club all about that. They will be holding their second meeting on September 23rd at 7:50 a.m. Email ebowers@phm.k12.in.us to learn more. The Penn Pool will be open for all students and community members for open swim on Mondays and Wednesdays from 7 to 9 p.m. This will be going on until October 12th and is free to everyone. The Girl Up Club will be having a second meeting on September 26th with 3:25 to 4:25 in room 101. They will be discussing their plans for the CYA fundraiser and field trips. Along with that, they will be speaking about influential women in their lives throughout history. Email frarnix@phm.k12.in.us for more information. Again, I'm Megan Gensing. Now back to the desk.
Remember, the Silver Mile Run for Education will be taking place at Penn High School on September 23rd and 24th. Get involved by coming to the parade and the Penn football game Friday, the fun zones and inflatables Saturday morning, and of course, the 5K race. All fundraising goes right back into our school community.
Penn Mart is now open. Students in Penn's exceptional education program have begun selling homemade crafts, which you can find in room 181.
Excuse me, guys.
Lucid footage.
Got a new one.
We're recording?
I think we're in the clear.
It's not fake.
He definitely did hear us.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Why do we do a quick interview?
We got a runner.
How are you guys doing today?
Pretty good, to be honest.
How about you? Yeah, pretty good.
I'm doing all right. Thanks for asking. That was really sincere. How's your day been going?
Pretty good, actually. Yeah.
Good. How's the school year been?
Good.
Cool. Yeah, that's great.
I'm working on school history. School comes first, as always.
Forensic science. We're trying to find fingerprints and
stuff. Oh, do you want my fingerprints? Is this good?
Let's see. All right, left off.
I mean, am I going to get, like,
in trouble
right now?
We're not testing anything.
No, I'm just kidding.
Okay. We're in the clear, all right. Let's get out of here. Any movies you've been enjoying lately? You just hit that. Oh, hit that Netflix. Ooh, something's good, right?
Oh, yeah. I haven't been watching any movies.
It's that TV show I know you've been watching.
Okay, 13 Reasons Why.
Ooh, you're going on late. That's late. Is it good? I never watched it.
It's mid.
Okay, you heard it first. Don't watch 13 Reasons Why. We're out of here.
That's all the time we have right now. I'm sorry, I don't know what to say.
Go Kingsman.
Hello, I'm Rashida Maheshwaram bringing you this week's sports news. This past Friday, the football team took home an NIC opener win against rival Elkhart Lions. With a defensive touchdown, Vincent Horner scoops and scores a strip sack caused by Ryan Fraser, Nolan McCullough with a 69-yard touchdown pass to DJ White and a rushing touchdown from McCullough. Late in the fourth quarter, it was 21-20, Kingsman, leading with 1 minute and 7 seconds left on the clock. Elkhart on the Penn's 20-yard line, Jackson Griffith came up with the game-winning interception to seal the game for the Kingsmen. When asked after the game by PNN reporter Maddox Reynolds, what was going through your mind when you sealed the game? Griffith responded, I'm him. Penn, three of the Kingsmen top players have been severely injured, forcing the team to adjust with their new lineup. In girls soccer, midfielder Sydney Sklarik and Megan Zhang and forward Isabella Pearson saw their season end due to torn ACLs. Sklarik, a senior, had started for the Kingsmen since her freshman year. Zhang, a sophomore, was injured in the team's preseason game against Homestead. Pearson, a freshman, is known as a star to be at Penn. Coach Jeff Hart claims that Quinn Marion, Sarah Tobin, Reagan DeMoss, and Jenny Keegan, among others, have taken leadership roles to help the team adjust to their current situation. While we haven't had the results we have wanted, these kids are playing hard, showing up every day, and eager to get better. The Kingsmen played on September 21st, but at the time of the recording, we don't have the score yet, so we'll give you that next week. Come support the Kingsmen this Saturday on September 24th at home against Noblesville and Guerin Catholic. Boys soccer battled St. Joe for a victory at home on Tuesday night. Penn was down 2-0, but came to win the game 3-2. Andre Gomez led the comeback with a goal from the box, and Nathaniel Nuth was right behind him with one for his own. Braden Murphy snapped the 2-2 tie with 8 minutes left in the game, scoring a huge goal. Boys soccer will play again. Last week, Penn volleyball played Riley. Penn won 3-0. Macy Hatkovich led the team with 6 kills and 15 assists. Georgia Pogue with 3 aces, 8 assists, and 8 digs. Penn played Marion last night, but of the time of this recording, we do not have those results yet. Good job and good luck to the volleyball team. The girls' cross-country team scored second place last Saturday before Valpo, who scored first place, and after 12th East Noble, who scored third place. Be sure to support your Kingsmen at the next meet this Saturday, on the 24th, at New Haven. The Kingsmen dominated East Noble in the tennis game on Monday. In two singles, Peter Clisson defeated Itor Bono with the score 7-6 and 6-1. And in three singles, Penn Evan Knapp beat East Noble's Cole Thompson with the score 6-0 and 6-1. For our Kingsmen double, David Bao and Quinn Lippert dominated to finish off the match and bring Penn home the big win. That's all for sports this week. Now back to Brendan and Kendall.
That's all we have for you this week, Penn.
Have a great week, and remember to follow us on all our socials at Penn News Network.
So, what are you doing on Friday?
Well, Kendall, I was thinking of going to the homecoming game.
Oh, that's fun. Well, what are you doing when you get home from that? I think you should start tuning into my new podcast, Maui's Music Movement.
I think I'll do that.
Yeah, it's great. Thank you. Pepperidge Farms remembers.
Oh, God.